Hey everybody, welcome to CRNT Designers. This is Chetan and now let's get started. To make the model, we need to add cylinder. So Shift A, add a cylinder, and we will go with the 32 words. After that, you need to go to the orthographic view and then scale the cylinder along the Z axis like this. First, we need to create the quick blockout. So that's why go to the edit mode, select the stop words and then scale them down and then move them along the Z axis like this. Next thing, just adjust the scale a little bit and then use the insert operation and then just move this face along the Z axis like this. And then one more time, adjust the scale and then extrude it along the Z axis like this and then delete that face. So just select this bottom face and then delete it. You will get this edge loop at the bottom. Just move it along the Z axis like this and just try to match it to the outer border edge loop and then scale them along the Z axis both. So it will get matched to the outer one. And then you need to add one more cube at there and then scale that cube along the X axis like this. And just you need to use it as a cutter object. So select the both object and use the boolean operation, which is difference. And then adjust the scale and its position so we can use it to create the boolean at there. After getting the satisfactory position, you can apply the boolean modifier. So select that object and then apply the boolean modifier and then you can delete that cutter object. After that, we need to work on its topology. So just select this word, right click, connect vertex path and create a path in between the words. And we want to use the mirror modifier, or you can say the symmetry. That's why you need to select this word, right click, connect vertex path, so we can delete the one side, one half of the model. Then go to the top view and then turn on your extreme mode, select these words and then delete them. Select these words and then delete them. After that, we will get this part only and we need to work on it and we need to create the right topology. So that's why select these words and press M and merge at last. And same thing here you need to do, select the words and press M and merge at last. So just select these words, press M and merge at last, then dissolve these words with the Control X. And then you can add one loop cut here. And then select these words, right click and then connect vertex path. Add the loop cut here and then select this word, right click and then connect vertex path. Add one more loop cut here and then select these words, right click and then connect vertex path. Then you can dissolve this edge loop with the Control X. And then select these edge loops and then double tap G for the edge slides. Give the right position to it. Then add one more loop cut here. Select these edge loops and then double tap G for the edge slide. And one more time you need to add loop cut at here. Same thing you need to do here. Select this edge loop and double tap G for the edge slide. And just try to give the right position to the word so we can keep the same distance in between the edge loops. And then add one more loop cut here. And then add one more loop cut here. But this time you need to select this edge loop and Control X, select this edge loop, double tap G for the edge slide. Just give the right position to this edge loop and then select these words and use the edge slide for these words. And just try to give the right position to them. And then select this word, right click and then connect vertex path and create a path in between the words. And you can select these words and you can use the edge slide to give the right position to them. And to keep that same distance in between these edge loops so we will get the smoother shading on these harder edges. And then you can add one loop cut like this. Add one loop cut like this. Add one loop cut here and then dissolve that edge and then Control X to dissolve these edges. Select these words and use the merge at last at there and you can create the right loop structure and right topology at there. And then you can add one loop cut like this to maintain that harder edge. And then use the edge slide here. And here you need to give the right position to words. And then you need to keep the same distance in between these words. We won't face those shading issues and those harder edges difficulties when we create something like this on a circular form. Then select these words and then right click connect vertex path. And here you need to create the edge loop structure or face loop structure. So that's why you need to add the loop cut like this. Then select these words and use the edge slide and just keep them close to this corner and then select these words and then right click and then connect vertex path. And just try to create that face loop structure around this boolean. And now it's look pretty well, so you can add the subdivision surface modifier and then add one loop cut here. And now you can see it's look pretty well. Shear smooth it and then increase that sub-D count up to 2. Now it's look pretty well. We need to work on its topology a little bit more. So you can add the mirror modifier here, so we can take the symmetry and take the symmetry along the x and y axis. Mirror modifier should be top of your sub-D modifier, and turn on that merging and clipping option in that mirror modifier. And you can see we got this kind of form, and it's look pretty well. Need to work on its topology at these two points, means those booleans. Then you can apply that mirror modifier and you can select these words, and then you can use the edge slide here. And same thing you need to do to this side also, or you can take the symmetry. And then you can add a few more loop cuts like this, and then select these words and then press M and merge at last. Or you can create a path in between the words like this. Select these words, right click and then connect vertex path, and then dissolve these edges. You can create this kind of topology at there to reduce these edges. It's like a welding method. So you can weld the words and you can reduce your topology. We are getting the decent result at there with this method. And we will create the loop structure here to reduce few more edges. So select these edges, Ctrl X to dissolve them, and then select this word, right click, connect vertex path, and then create that loop structure so we can dissolve few more edges. And we will get a decent shading. Now we need to take the symmetry at there so we can reduce this edge, or we can dissolve that edge. So that's why I take the symmetry along the Y axis. And then you can Ctrl X to dissolve that edge. It's look well as compared to the last one. And then take the symmetry along the X axis also. You can see we are able to solve that shading issue at this corners little bit. So you can refine this model as much as you want. Then select this bottom edge. There are 36 words. And here are 40 words. Select this edge loop and E to extrude it and scale it along the X and Y axis. After that, add a few more loop cuts like this. On this edge loop, we have the 40 words. And on the outer edge loop, we have 36 words. So that's why we need to merge the words like this, and we need to reduce the vertex count. So just select these words and press M and merge at the center, or you can use the any option at there. And then reduce this vertex count. And now you can see we got the 36 words. So just select this outer edge loop also, and then use the bridge edge loop. And then you can add few more loop cuts on the model to maintain the form. And now you can see it's look pretty well. We are trying to maintain the good design and good topology. We are working on both. We want to achieve that design with a good topology also, with a good shading. So that's why you can select these words, and you can keep a little bit of distance in between these words. So you can use the edge slide at there, and you can avoid that weird shading, and we can improve that shading at these corners. So you can see it's look pretty well. You can compare with the side one. We can take the symmetry. If it's look good, then just take the symmetry along the X and Y axis. And you can see we are able to maintain the good shading, good topology, and good design on the model. So in this way, you can create this kind of models. You can see from the MATCAP view, you can see its topology. So thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe our YouTube channel. Bye bye. See you next video. Take care.